Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Always Secured Automation. Differential pressure flow meters are widely used in the industry for the measurement of flow in a closed pipe. This kind of flow meter consists of two parts. The primary element. The differential pressure transmitter. The DP flow meter will calculate the flow rate by measuring the differential pressure across a primary element. Various types of primary elements can be used to obtain differential pressure. Some of the most common primary elements are orifice plates, P-taut tubes and venturi tubes. Although DP-type flow transmitters are known for their high performance and reliability, they will need a recalibration from time to time. For the purpose of the calibration procedure that we will describe further on, we will consider a DP transmitter with an orifice plate as the primary element. Relationship between flow rate and differential pressure. Q equals K multiplied by square root of DP. Where Q is the volumetric flow rate. K is a constant. DP is the differential pressure. And the square root function represents the relationship between velocity and pressure. From this equation, we can see that an increase in differential pressure will result in an increase in flow rate. However, the relationship between flow rate and differential pressure is not linear but square-rooted. A 25% increase in differential pressure will result in a 50% increase in flow rate. Square root of 0.25, dp, equals 0.5, flow rate. What is low flow cutoff? Let's have another look at the DP vs flow curve above. Check in particular how the curve behaves in the region around the origin. In this region, the slightest change in differential pressure causes the flow to change rapidly. A little noise on the DP signal gets multiplied by a factor of 10 or more on the flow signal. This makes the flow signal very unstable and unreliable. Therefore, vendors will define a low flow cutoff for the flow meter. That means that the output signal will be set to 4 mA once the flow drops below 10%. The low flow cutoff is only present in DP transmitters with internal square root extraction. If the square rooting is done by the PLC, DCS, then the DP transmitter has a linear output and the low flow cutoff should be programmed in the PLC, DCS. A low flow cutoff at a flow rate of 10% corresponds to an output of 5.6 mA. So, between 4 and 5.6 mA there is no useful measurement possible because of too much inaccuracy. All of that will have consequences on the calibration of our DP flow transmitter. For a typical 5-point calibration of a transmitter with linear output, the test points would be 0, 25, 50, 75, and 100% of the flow rate. But, if the DP flow transmitter performs the square root calculation and a low flow cutoff is considered, it has no sense to have a test point below 10% of the flow rate. So, the test points should be 10, 25, 50, 75, and 100% of the flow rate. What are the tools needed to calibrate a DP type flow transmitter? Besides the DP flow transmitter itself, we will need the below mentioned tools to perform a calibration. A calibrated pressure calibrator capable of indicating pressure in mmHg2O, because here the DP transmitter for measuring flow has a range in mmHg2O. A calibrated pressure gauge of the appropriate range. A 24 VDC power supply, if the pressure transmitter is not connected to the system and needs an external power supply. A digital multimeter. A heart communicator. Some important checklist to consider before starting the calibration of a DP type flow transmitter. Check all the tools available. Check tools calibration dates validity. Obtain a work permit with all risk assessments performed. Data sheet for DP flow transmitter available. Bypass all the interlocks present for the DP type flow transmitter. Follow the proper bypass procedure and fill out all necessary interlock bypass requests. Inform all involved process operators. The DP type flow transmitter calibration procedure. When all the preparatory work has been completed, we can now start calibrating the DP flow transmitter. Arrange all the tools. The DP type power transmitter can be powered through the field cables connecting the DP transmitter to the system or by using an external power supply. If the differential pressure flow transmitter is in the field, then isolate the DP transmitter. Flush the differential pressure transmitter in a closed drain if it comes into contact with a dangerous process medium like a hazardous chemical. Connect the power supply, the multimeter, and the DP flow transmitter in a series configuration. Make sure to connect the multimeter leads to the MA terminal and the common terminal. Now connect the DP transmitter to the pressure calibrator using the appropriate tubing. Here we can use poor tubing because the pressure to be applied to the DP flow transmitter is in the MMH2O range. Connect a precision pressure gauge of appropriate range to the pressure generating device if for any reason this device would not display the generated pressure. Prior to starting the calibration, it is necessary to determine whether the square root extraction takes place in the DP transmitter or in the PLC, DCS. The output value, MA, of the DP transmitter will depend on where this square root extraction occurs. So, check the datasheet or the configuration parameters of the DP transmitter to see if the transmitter does the square root extraction. A third option is to simulate 25% of the DP range with the pressure calibrator and look at the output, MA, of the DP transmitter. If the output is about 12 mA, the SQRT extraction is performed by the transmitter. If the output is about 8 mA, the SQRT extraction is performed by the PLC, DCS. Now that we know where the square root extraction is done and we have calculated our test points, we can start the validation procedure. We will do an, as found, test on all test points. This test is done for two reasons. If this test proves that the instrument is still within the required accuracy for the application, then we do not have to recalibrate it. With this test, we will record the history of the device performance data. This will be helpful to decide if we need to shorten or prolong the calibration frequency. We will use the following table for our, as found, test. We have filled in our test points based on a DP transmitter with square root extraction. You can see that our test points are going in ascending order from minimum to maximum value and then in descending order back to minimum. This is important because the results can be different for the same test point when approached from below or from above. So, be very careful when approaching a test point not to overshoot it because if you have to come down again it will not give you the same result. Start the validation procedure with zero pressure on the pressure calibrator and increase the pressure until you reach the pressure value of the first test point. Note down the reading from the pressure calibrator in the second column, applied DP, and the reading from the transmitter in the fifth column, transmitter output flow. Similarly, apply the pressures of the other test points in the order they appear in the table. Note down the readings from the pressure calibrator and the transmitter in the appropriate columns. Every time you reach a new test point, the applied pressure value should remain stable for 30 seconds before reading the output value from the transmitter. If the pressure drops during these 30 seconds, then there is a leakage in the tubing or an issue with the pressure calibrating device. Identify the root cause and attend to it. As the square root extraction is done by the transmitter, its output represents the flow rate. To calculate the error on the output, we will have to compare the measured flow rate with the applied flow rate. As we can only apply a DP, we will have to calculate the applied flow with the following formula. Do this calculation for every test point and fill in the flow rates in the third column, applied flow. Now calculate the error percent from the flow values we got with the next formula. If the calculated errors are all well within the required accuracy for the application, then the DP type flow transmitter is okay and should not be recalibrated. If the error obtained from the calculations is more than the required accuracy for the application, then a calibration of the DP flow transmitter is needed. A recalibration of a DP flow transmitter with internal square root extraction consists of a lower trim at the 10% flow point and a span trim at the 100% flow point. We cannot do a zero trim for a transmitter with square root extraction because the zero point is too unstable. Any fluctuation in the input signal, no matter how small, is multiplied tenfold at the output. First, apply 1% DP on the input of the transmitter and check if this corresponds to 10% flow at the output. If this is not okay, then start a lower trim at the 1% input, 10% output level, not zero, using the Hart communicator. Now check the 100% flow point by applying the 100% DP pressure to the input of the transmitter. If the reading does not indicate 100% flow, perform a span trim using the Hart calibrator. When the lower trim and span trim is completed, the transmitter is calibrated. All that remains is to return the transmitter to service. Inform the operator that the DP flow transmitter calibration job is finished and remove any interlock bypasses you placed at the start. Thank you for watching our video.